Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. With immense pleasure, I welcome you to the National Role Play and Folk Dance Competition organized under National Population Education Project by the Department of Education and Social Sciences, NCERT. This program is being organized from 5th to 8th of December 2017. I extend a very warm welcome to Professor Senapati, Director NCERT, Professor Saroj Yadav, Dean Academic NCERT, Major Harsh Kumar, Secretary NCERT, all the dignitaries, jury members, invited guests, heads of the departments, colleagues, teachers, and also my dear children. Now I request Professor Senapati, Professor Saroj Yadav, Major Harsh Kumar to kindly light the lamp.
This program we initiated in 2009. And actually, our objective was to come out with a transactional strategy which can be effectively used not only in the area like adolescence education or population education, but also in the area of, you can say, teaching other subjects. I thought of stopping it also, but because since 2009 we are doing this activity. But when we discussed in the PPR project progress review meeting held with the states and union territory, they are saying it is the most cost effective activity, that we are not paying anything up to the district level, and whatever we are paying, only we are paying their TA and DA at the state level. So through these activities we are reaching, you can say, to a large number of children, because these children are only those which are selected at the state level. But there are large number of children who participated at the district level, who participated at the school level, who participated at the regional level. So in a way we are covering large number of children. Adolescence, we all know, is a stage of life full of happiness, full of charms, but at the same time it is challenges also, because during this stage we are more energetic, but sometimes we become victim to certain bad habits also. The drug abuse is one of the area where our adolescents are suffering from it. Large number of children are becoming habitual of taking not only the drugs which are illegal, but also which are legally available as medicinal drugs. So we thought of about organizing this role play and folk dance competition. And in this folk dance and role play competition, there were certain themes were given to children. For example, healthy relationship among adolescent was one theme, that how to have relationship during adolescent which are healthy, which are happy, which are responsible. Charms and challenges of adolescent. The adolescence is a period full of charms, but at the same time if we will not take care of it, it is a challenge also. HIV and AIDS, stigmatization in HIV is more dangerous than in the HIV infection itself. Causes and impact of drug abuse, that why the children are taking drugs or misuse of drugs. So these are the four themes we gave to the children of role play. In folk dance, we included some more themes like equal opportunity for boys and girls, removal of female feticide, because sex ratio in India is, though it has improved in 2011, but 0 to 6 has gone down. So that means that the newborn children are not taking birth as it should have been. Respect and care for elders. In India, we never thought of having, you can say, old age home. But now, there are old age homes are also, and the parents are being left out there. So how to respect, how to care for the elders is also one of the theme which we have given for folk dance. Similarly, protection of environment, because pollution is too much. And particularly if you see in Delhi, those who have come from distance, from the hilly area, they must be feeling the impact of this pollution. So pollution is increasing, how to protect the environment? That is an environment, when we say that, doesn't mean only the physical environment, but also the social environment, the ambience, the peace and safety and security. And the drug abuse is also part of the, you can say, folk dance. In role play as well as in folk dance, we invited children from class, in role play, class 9th. In folk dance, from class 8th also have been included. 4 to 5 children in role play, whereas 4 to 6 students in folk dance have been included. We also requested states to include children, special children also, if they are there, and there are separate marks those for those teams who have inclusive, you can say, students in their group. Language is again Hindi and English, so though no regional language will be used, so please don't use regional language, because your marks will be deducted if you use the regional language. So it is better to use Hindi or English. Number of players should also not be more or less. So for role play, 4 to 5, and for folk dance, 4 to 6, that is there. Time we have given for role play, for example, 6 to 8 minutes, whereas for folk dance, it is given for 8 to 10 minutes, that is there. In role play, please make sure that you should not use any costumes, because sometime, or anything, if you are playing a role of a teacher, no chair, nothing. So you have to project yourself as you are a student and not using any other thing. So no costume, no material, nothing to be used in, you can say, in role play. Whereas in folk dance, you are free because you have to wear the dress. You can use that. That is very important. There are certain criteria of judging. This is particularly for judges. That coverage of theme is very important. We are given these themes, for example, charms and challenges of adolescent for role play. And there are 4 themes: a healthy relationship among adolescents, HIV/AIDS stigmatization, causes and impact of drug abuse. So these are for role play. So therefore, you have to see that whether it is up to the theme or not, and for that 25 marks are there. So out of 100, the judges have to judge the team. 25 marks is the presentation of role play, that how they used to present. Similarly, reflection of life skills, critical thinking, creative thinking, stress management. So how they are showing that life skill, that also you have to judge. And that the maximum marks we have given to life skill, that is 35 marks. Effectiveness of evaluation between role play and audience. Because in this role play, we have also made provision that audience can ask questions. And if the audience asks questions and the role player answers it, so there are 10 marks for that also. Participation of differently abled children is there. If there is one child, then we have given 5 marks for them also. So these are the criteria on the basis of which we will evaluate the children, and the judges will evaluate those children, because they are already, you can say, participated at the national level. So criteria you all know, and the decision of the judges will be final. So I'll request all states and union territory coordinators and children, please accept the decision of the judges, because all are neutral. You do not know them, they don't belong to your state, so it's a, basically they will evaluate you in a fair manner. So this is all about, you can say, role play and folk dance competition. Best of luck, and I hope you all are the winners and you all win. Whatever your position will be there, our objective is not to have competition, as I number of time I used to say. Our objective that you must enjoy, you must learn. These are the activities through which learning can take place in a much better way. Thank you so much.
I request the students from Kendriya Vidyalaya to come on stage. Kendriya Vidyalaya NCERT. They are going to perform a Maharashtrian dance, Asai Jogwan Nritya. This dance is in the praise of Amba Devi, invoking the spirit of Shakti.
Hey, I am Babai Chanavada, Udha.
ನಿರ್ಗುಣ ಪ್ರಕಟಲಿ ಭವಾನಿ ಅನ್ನದಿ ನಿರ್ಗುಣ ಪ್ರಕಟಲಿ ಭವಾನಿ ಮೋಹ ಮಹಿಷಾಸುರ ಮರದಾನ ಲಾಗೋನಿ ತ್ರಿವಿಧ ತಾಪಾಜಿ ಕರಾವಯ ಧಾಡನಿ ತ್ರಿವಿಧ ತಾಪಾಜಿ ಕರಾವಯ ಧಾಡನಿ ನ ಭಕ್ತ ಲಾಗೇತು ಪಾವಸಿ ನಿರ್ವಾಣಿ ಐತ ಜೋಗವಾ ಜೋಗವಾ ಮಾಗೇನ ಐತ ಜೋಗವಾ ಜೋಗವಾ ಮಾಗೇನ
बच्चों, आपको एक बात बताऊं कि पढ़ाई तो सिर्फ एक पार्ट है। यहाँ पे उपस्थित सारे लोगों को पता होगा कि घर पे लोग बहुत प्रेशर करते हैं कि आप ये पढ़िए, वो पढ़िए, ये बनना है जीवन में। जीवन में क्या बनना है वो तो आप तय करिए, लेकिन इसके साथ इस तरह के प्रोग्राम्स या एक्स्ट्रा को करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज़, स्पोर्ट्स, इसका जीवन में बहुत महत्व है। और जैसे जैसे आप आगे जाएंगे आपको पता लगेगा कि इसका कितना बड़ा महत्व है जीवन में। पढ़ाई सिर्फ एक पार्ट है, इसके अलावा जब आप लोक नृत्य करते हैं या रोल प्ले भूमिका निर्वहन, जिंदगी में पता नहीं कितनी जगह आपको कितनी भूमिकाएं करनी पड़ेंगी। एक व्यक्ति अपने जीवन में, अपने पर्सनल जीवन में भी आप सोचिए आप अपनी कितनी भूमिकाएँ करते हैं। आप किसी के पुत्र होते हैं, किसी के पिता होते हैं, किसी के पति होते हैं, किसी के भाई होते हैं, और इसको इसका निर्वहन करना उतना ही कठिन है। इन सब कार्यक्रमों से आपको वो सीखने की बहुत प्रेरणा मिलती है। और जीवन में वही व्यक्ति अच्छा कर पाता है, कोई टॉपर हो वो हर जगह अच्छा नहीं कर सकता। टॉपर एक सब्जेक्ट में, एक पढ़ाई में। अभी एक हाल की घटना थी जिसपे हार्वर्ड यूनिवर्सिटी में रिसर्च भी किया गया, और रिसर्च का मुद्दा ये बना कि ताज होटल में जब अटैक हुआ तो वहाँ के जो कर्मचारी थे, जो वहाँ के मैनेजर्स थे, उन्होंने अपना फ्रंट छोड़ा नहीं और कई मारे गए उसमें। तो पता लगा कि ताज अपना रिक्रूटमेंट किस प्रकार से करता है। रिक्रूटमेंट उन लोगों का किया जाता है जो कि बड़ों का कितना रिस्पेक्ट करते हैं, अपने आसपास कैसा व्यवहार रखते हैं। और टॉपर्स कोई ज़रूरी नहीं है कि टॉपर्स का किया जाए। तो जो इस तरह की एक्स्ट्रा को करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज़ है, और बड़े आप लोगों के लिए बड़े गर्व का विषय है कि आप पूरे अपने राज्यों से जीत करके इस बड़े मंच पे आप पहुँचे हैं। और पूरी ऑब्वियसली आपने अभी तक जो किया होगा पूरी तन्मयता के साथ किया होगा, पूरी मेहनत के साथ किया होगा। इसमें आपके टीचर्स का, जो जिन्होंने आपको सिखाया, और आपका अपना खुद का, और जो ये चार दिवसीय प्रोग्राम चलेगा उसमें जो आप हासिल करेंगे वो आपके आगामी जीवन के लिए बहुत महत्वपूर्ण साबित होगा, इस बात का मुझे पूरा विश्वास है। और इस बात को आप खुद भी अनुभव करेंगे, और यहाँ तक पहुँचने के लिए आपने कितनी मेहनत करी होगी ये आप सभी जानते होंगे। मैं परिषद के डिपार्टमेंट का, DESS का, और इस प्रोग्राम की निर्देशिका का, और उनके पूरे टीम का, और निसंदेह रूप से हमारे निदेशक महोदय का, जिसमें इस तरह का प्रोग्राम कंडक्ट हो रहा है, NCERT में इस विविध प्रोग्राम कंडक्ट होता, उनको मैं बधाई देता हूँ। जय हिंद, जय भारत।
आई वुड लाइक टू वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस नेशनल फोक डांस कॉम्पिटिशन। Really, this is a very good opportunity for all of us to see our children who have come from different part of the country. I would like to congratulate all the children and the teachers from 28 states and also from our 4 RIDM schools. Those who have come to this national level competition, because it is a difficult task. I know you have participated at your school level, district level, then state level, then you have come to the national level. and we should give a big hand to our children who have come to this stage. Really, I appreciate your effort, your contribution, and I hope you will contribute a lot for yourself and also for the development of this nation, because you have shown your talents. You might be thinking why you are organizing this program. Every year we are organizing this program, not only this program, many programs of this type. Recently, we conducted science exhibition in Bhopal, and children from all the states participated. We conducted Yoga Olympiad, and we are going to conduct Kala Utsav. You know, these are the extension activities of NCERT. NCERT has four mandates. We conduct research, we develop different types of materials, we conduct training program, we conduct extension activities, different types of extension activities, just to bridge the gap between our school and between our culture. You see, why I am saying our culture? Because culture is a very comprehensive term, very inclusive term. It includes everything. Our way of life, our language, our thought, our belief, our value. Everything is included in our culture and our school. What is happening in our school? You will find, all of us will agree, there is a gap between our culture and between our school. You might be thinking why it is so, because now our focus has been shifted. If you go back to history, you will see in the beginning of the civilization, there was no school, but education was there. And people or children were learning informally, incidentally, in the process of living. But when society became complex, complicated, school came into existence, so that school will help our children to adjust effectively with the changing society. Now we are living in 21st century. You see how our school is helping our children to adjust effectively with the changing scenario. What we are doing inside the classroom, inside the school, and what is expected from us. There is a gap. And these, I don't say by conducting these activities only we can minimize the gap, but these are the examples. Just this will help us to bring about change in our mindset. Yes, we have to go beyond classroom. We have to go beyond classroom, beyond school, and we have to help our children to develop their talents, develop their innate potentialities, what they have inherited from their parents and ancestors, so that they can grow to the maximum extent and they can really adjust effectively and contribute significantly for the development of this nation. That is our intention. We all are Indians. We are proud of our country. We are proud of our culture. All the time we say we believe in Vasudeva Kutumbakam. We believe in Sarve Bhavanta Sukhina. And we have very rich history, because if you see in ancient time, we had very good institutions in our country, Nalanda, Takshashila. People from all over the country were coming to our country just to learn. And what is that learning? Why they were coming? Because our intention is not to impart only the skills. Our focus was on character. You see, Swami Vivekananda, what he said? He said, we want that education by which character is formed, by which strength of mind is increased, intellect is expanded, one is able to stand on his own feet. This was the interpretation of Swami Vivekananda. That means our focus was on character. In ancient time, even in modern time, if you see the philosophy of Aurobindo, Gandhi, and Rabindranath Tagore, And you will find all the time we put lot of emphasis on character formation, lot of emphasis on our culture, lot of emphasis on our tradition, because we believe in joint family system. We expect our children should learn many things from our family, and it should help our children to develop their values, their culture, their way of life. That was the expectation, but now there is a gap. That is why we are conducting different types of activities just to bring our children outside the classroom. We encourage our teacher that just you help the children to participate in different activities. You help them to become more creative, because that is the need of hour that is required in 21st century. Otherwise, our children cannot compete with the children of other countries. If we cannot help them to develop their character, develop their values, and if we cannot help them to develop their potentialities, then they cannot compete with the children of other countries. If we simply help them just to prepare for the exam, that is not going to help our children to achieve the goal. That is why there is need of conducting different types of competitions, different types of activities outside the classroom, outside the school, so that we really can help our children to develop their potentialities. And we know our children have come from different states, they have different language, they have different culture, they have different value system, but when they meet here and when they live together, that means they learn many things from each other. This is also another type of learning, and that we should encourage. Ultimately, we all are one, we all are Indian, and we have to develop Indian culture and Indian tradition. That is why our children should learn from the beginning what is the other language, and they should develop respect for other language, for other religion and other community. And that is something great that we can achieve by conducting such type of competitions, such type of activities outside the classroom and outside the school, both at the district level, national level, state level, and so that we can really do something and promote our culture. That is our intention. I'm really happy that this project, Department of Education and Social Science has taken lead, and our national population education project is leading this program. You know, our Dean, Professor Saroj Yadav, she is leading this program, and along with her team, and every year she is conducting this program. I'm really happy, and we should also congratulate her and her team for organizing such an event, and every year, not only this one, Yoga Olympiad and other things. And I'm really happy that all my colleagues are here. They have also contributed significantly for smooth organization of this program, and really this is a very good program, and we should participate in this program, and we should encourage our children to participate in different types of program, so that really they can develop their innate potentialities. And I hope you will enjoy this program, because this is not one day program. This will continue till 8th of December, and you will participate in different activities, and you will enjoy this program. Once again, I welcome you all to this program, and hope you will enjoy this program. Jai Hind.